dear friends, this is Emma Lehmann and the online video course PianoWell. So let me explain you why I decided to make this crazy video about Etude by Czerny. Probably some of you know that during 6 months of PianoWell training program, my students learn very highly professional technique, and they're using some simple exercises to develop internal ear and correct tone production to achieve this technique, and they're using some scales to master this technique and arpeggios and octave and chords. So after that program, I really suggest my students to go with Etude by Czerny, because surprisingly they have all types of technique that students will need in the future to prepare any concert, concerto or piece. So I simply decided to make these tutorials because, you know, I already made videos about how to analyze and play scales, arpeggios, octave and chords, so I thought it could be a good idea to continue this topic. And so I'm gonna make as many videos as I can, guys, to show you how I analyze and learn Etudes by Czerny that I have chosen for my students. There are actually 22 etudes that develop all types of techniques, and they are excellent. They're just perfectly for strengthening and even your finger muscles, for developing these tenacious sensations in your fingertips and fingers, to master this rapid technique of elbow movement and position changes, to play all the big leaps and arpeggios with clarity and confidence. And there will be etudes for similar and contrary scale motion and for different types of runs and turns and passages. Also, etudes to develop our thumb technique and to strengthen our fifth and fourth finger, our weak fingers. Etudes for mastering this elbow technique in position changes, big leaps, arpeggios and broken chords. And finally, it is for double notes, repetitions, chords and octaves. As I said before, it really has all types of technique that you're gonna use later while playing etudes by Chopin, Liszt or Rachmaninoff. But the most important thing that these etudes are perfect to simply develop musical meaning of expressions from PianoWell training program. It's very easy to analyze the music and to imagine notes in your head in string group of instruments, very easy to find sound movement. I also send my students the score where I myself circle the notes for position changes to move the elbow. Later students, this way they will just learn how to make it by themselves, so this is an example of such score. And the harmony of this piece are super easy, so it doesn't take any effort to imagine them. It's simply like just triads, like tonic, subdominant, dominant, tonic. Maybe a little bit more complicated than this, but this is a very good beginning for you to start mastering this harmony. And I absolutely love dynamics, these all rapid changes, you know, in volume, crescendos, diminuendos, piano forte. And of course it's absolutely excellent material for students to develop this ability to imagine dynamics very precisely, very accurately. And also it's a good material for developing, for analyzing phrasing in the piece, to find all the limits of motifs and phrases and sentences, and to find the limits of form. And also this etude really benefits if you play it with internal pulsation, like with time technique that we learned before. So actually, lastly, the main reason why I decided to start playing etude is because right now in my life great changes are coming, and I don't know where I'm gonna work, I don't know where I'm gonna live, I don't know in which country I'm gonna live. So it's like really like global things in my life are happening, and it's gonna be like for a couple of months more before I get any clarity. And that's kind of a little bit sad and brings me down, and maybe this is the reason why lately I never posted anything. But I decided to start playing this music because, I mean, the best thing is, you know, to laugh about anything. Like, even when there is no reason, the best thing is to laugh. And I think the Etude by Czerny is just a pure laugh, a pure joy and happiness. So it really turns me on and brings me up in this like very sad time in my life. And so they, like I said, it's because this etude is very simple to make. I made this etude during a couple of days, and it has very bright harmony, very bright dynamics and clear phrasing, so all together gives you so much positive energy. It just really energizes you for the whole day. So I think it's a great music to play. So I'm gonna go ahead, guys, and again, as usually, show you step by step how analyze the piece, and just want to remind those of you who have no idea about PianoWell system that these tutorials are meant for those people who are familiar with the system. If you have any questions about any musical means of expression I'm gonna talk about over here, just check the description of this video. It has all the lessons of the course, so you can go ahead and just check what I'm talking about. Okay, let's go ahead. Okay guys, so we're gonna start with analyzing which timbres we're gonna use here. And the right hand, it's obvious, we're gonna imagine violins all the way from beginning till the end, because we basically play in this part of the keyboard all the time. And left hand, you can start from like cellos and while you're going up, so you change it to violas or maybe even sometimes violins if it's very high. But I think like violas the maximum. Here you can use violins. Anyway, so basically we're gonna use violins in the right hand and mostly cellos and violas in the left hand. After that, we imagine every note still with glissando, with correct sound movement, and we are following our wrist with this movement. So if the note to the left, then we move our wrist to the left, the note to the right, we move our wrist to the right. Imagine glissando between notes. Oh, even in this little distance of second between notes. And well, you can imagine first right hand, then left hand, then imagine them together, but make sure that when you imagine notes together, you have to imagine every single note in your head. Even if sometimes you have something like this. Three notes in the left hand and one note in the right hand, so all of them four notes together. Make sure that you do this. If you still cannot, then come back to the polyphonic ear and just imagine notes sequentially first and then together, just like we did all the time before. The elbow movement, well, since I already made it, I just can include it in my video and just take a look at this right now. So this is an idea for you how you circle the notes for your elbow movement and position changes. And so after this, you simply imagine every note in the strings with correct movement, and you play it with right wrist and elbow movements. That's it, nothing else. To the right, since you're gonna play high, and etc. And after that, you're playing it with intonation, with weight, and these are some fragments where you need to intonate your sparsandos, so make sure you intonate them in the right way. How we do this in the lesson of articulations. So over here, la, 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 la. And all this staccato, la, 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 because as we know, if we correctly intonate articulation, it becomes part of our intonation. And it really changes the character of music. We can really feel that, and I bet you can feel it when I'm playing. It's very expressive. Yeah, so make sure that you intonate every sparsando and every accent by the rule of articulation. So this is how it looks while playing with intonation. Then we're gonna listen to the harmonies, so let's go and pick up some harmonies from here, especially from the single notes. So basically, it's, we can go like this. It's C major 8. the tonic dominant all the time. Fingertips, because it changes the vibrations and the color of the timbre of note that we imagine. Okay. Favorite part in the whole etude, to imagine dynamics over here. And you can see it starts piano, then it goes to crescendo, then forte, then fortissimo, then suddenly piano, then again crescendo, then forte, diminuendo, suddenly forte, diminuendo. I think it contains so many changes over here, just like in the whole concerto, during three pages. So you have to imagine everything very clear, and if it's soft, then try your best to imagine as soft as possible. Is it crescendo, then every single note has to be a little bit louder, and you have to have this clear idea, you know, in the whole this fragment starting from piano to forte, during two lines this crescendo is going on. So you have to know exactly on which bar you imagine, on which dynamics, which bar is gonna be mezzo piano, which bar is gonna be mezzo forte, and then again crescendo, and there is also between mezzo forte and forte, there is also so many like huge range of dynamics that you have to make. So make sure you make all of these guys, even over here, when you come forte, and the very next note is already gonna be in the piano. So make sure you do this. So this is how it looks like to imagine this piece in the timbre of strings, in the harmony, with dynamics, with movement, with glissando between notes, and playing with correct wrist and elbow movement, intonating every note and every articulation, playing with weight. So many things. Even here, this diminuendo, you know. And see, every next note is a little bit softer, so you have to achieve the same thing while playing. Then it will bring this, you know, lively and rapid and, you know, very joyful character of music. Always changes very fast. And about voicing, I would definitely imagine right hand all the time closer. So I would highlight, I would voice the right hand. When it goes over here, this time, please do not do this. So we're gonna find the melody even here. So we're gonna imagine closer the top voice. Where it comes to this point where we have runs in both hands. Again, if you do this without any voicing, if you make it without any voicing, then it would sound very clumsy, you know? But if you voice the right hand and left hand on the background, it's much easier to play. Changes the character of music, so keep it light, keep it light. And this one too, and backward. My left hand is still quite soft, even though it's fortissima, it under my right hand. And because of this, it creates this clarity while playing this etude. Very clear feeling. So again, guys, when you imagine voicing, you simply, you know, you can even vision this, you kind of stand beside these instruments, for example, even though they play piano. Because you stand right beside them, you hear them more clear. And it creates this balance between hands. Okay, then we simply imagine this etude in sound texture, in this texture of deep water, and you imagine it in sound texture, in harmony, dynamics, and voicing, and then you play it, and again, just remind you, we do this anyway, even though this etude is supposed to be light and like sparks everywhere, you can see from my playing, it doesn't change the character of music. So eventually, even making sound texture, it really benefits for this etude. And as you notice, I never used any pedal over here while playing this etude. And it sounds quite nice, so you can stick with this idea. Or if you want, you may try to add some pedal over here. Very fast, very straight pedal. But yeah, don't overuse it anyway. Be very careful. Usually I think you're not supposed to use any pedal in this etude. And in the next part, musical speech, we're gonna play while feeling emotional meaning of each interval. And this is all seconds, then seven that have the same meaning in seconds. So basically, you have to intonate every single second. And third up. So it's quite nice, but I think musical speech is quite simple here. Usually if you go by runs, it's like, you know, seconds and sevenths. sometimes worth fifth. It really helps you over here, because as you know, musical speech not only enrich our playing, make it more expressive, but also it really helps us with big leaps over here. When level goes, I really suggest you every time, this is basically second, right, the meaning of second, so every time keep in mind this is second down, and intonate it the same way. It will help your fifth finger to exert and be activated much faster, and make sure that it will always hit the right note. And when you combine it with right hand, it's gonna be sixth in the right hand and second in the left, then five and two, then they goes both together, kind of second here, so it's very easy, intonate in both hands, and again different sixth and second, five and second, concentrate on the right notes, because I think this is the most difficult part in this etude. And that's it, guys. So just use this technique all the time. And the next one is phrasing. So I'm gonna play again by motifs first, and emphasize the main interval. Just to tell you that I think one motif here is one bar. And sometimes it starts from middle of the bar till the middle of next bar, but you have an idea of the limit. So the first motif goes this way. So basically everything to descending seven. When we distribute weight while playing and bring more weight naturally to the main interval in the motif. Thank you. maximum, so to let you know where the main interval in the motif and where are the limits of the motif. So the next one I'm gonna go by phrases, and phrase will consist of two motifs, sometimes three motifs, and as usually I'm gonna play, and I'm saying first more means in this phrase first motif is more important, or second less means second motif less important. So let's try. So first less. I make it three motifs, so first less, second one, third less, something like that. Now first less, second one, first less, second one, third less. And guys, you can be free, you can arrange as you want. I'm not saying that my interpretation is perfect. Maybe I wasn't very... I don't know. I'm still not sure about all these two lines, so maybe you can find a better way. Anyway. So next time. First less. Second more. Now here I'm making first more. Second less. Will be more important than another one, and basically that will be your homework, because it's too easy. You can find it by yourself. It really helps you to distribute energy while playing and to keep your body and finger and hands light while playing, so you don't get fatigued and tired too fast. With the form of music, we need to find the beginning of music, the development, rising to climax, climax, and conclusion. So I think this etude consists of two parts, and each part has this little plot, this little hymn. So the very beginning is beginning. So bar 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is beginning. And after that, bar 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 is development. Then I'm going to a little little bit deeper. Here it's starting, you know, like rising to climax, and over here I'm starting making combination parts, especially here. And so that would be it. After this I go down again because this is the beginning of next part of Etude. So this is another beginning. From here, right, development. Then again, I'm going to the culmination, so I think this is a good place to make our rising to climax. Laughter passages. So basically these 2.5 lines belong to culmination part. And the end makes the whole, you know, meaning of this etude. This is just conclusion. So this one. Very funny conclusion. So this etude has beginning, development, intensification, rising to climax, climax. Then it has again another part with beginning, rising to climax, climax, and this climax is bigger than the climax of the first part. And after this, this couple of lines that is conclusion. This part is conclusion. And of course we're gonna also make it with emotional image, like this level when we play the city, then feel this absolutely bright, lively, happy character of music in the distance between every note, through our intonation, through our musical speech. And we're doing well within our phrasing, and we do it with our form. And then in the very last step, we're gonna use time. So guys, I myself tried to experiment it here, and I tried to pulsate by crotchets or quarters, or by half of the bar. And honestly, I couldn't find any big difference. So for you, you can choose either pulsate, feel the pulsation like this, or eventually, when I played, I choose a pulsate by crotchet because I think when you need to make steady tempo, you have to make it with more frequent pulsation inside, so it helps you a lot. And basically, that's it. You tune into the image of the piece, feel it in the form of music, and this feel, you give this image a heartbeat, because this our pulsation is a certain heartbeat of music that gonna help us to play in steady tempo. So if you feel, if you play it slow, you have to feel this pulsation anyway. So it's pulsation is very like moderate, but it's gonna it's gonna organize everything that we did before, because all this, you know, tempo deviations, all this rubato that we would naturally make while making so many musical means of expression in this music, we're gonna now subdue to this steady limits of time. So we give this piece a heartbeat and eventually when you want to play it faster, you feel this pulsation first faster The very last stage you do artistry, that again will all also help you to play it more steady and do everything more confident while playing and performing in front of audience. That's it. And like I said, it really, this etude is just a candy. It's so delicious and you can make it very fast, during, okay, for you maybe during 1 week. And you will enjoy this music, really, because playing romantic music is very nice, but sometimes it's overwhelming because of all this, you know, like too much emotions, sometimes not positive emotions, but these clear things, it's like playing Bach sometimes, it really clarify everything. I think Bach and Czerny are the best in this case. So guys, I really suggest you to play this music and hope you enjoy this video. I want to thank all of you for your support and for your very nice comments. And I do love you guys, I do love you. Everything I do is for you, to help you. And please be free to pass this free PianoWell program. I will help you, and it's just my pleasure, really. It's my pleasure to communicate with you and to know and to share with you your happiness and joy. Okay, bye-bye. See you next time. I hope I will see you next time. Really don't know when. Bye.